Here we have an active-active cluster with all servers active. This cluster requires load distribution among the different servers, which can be either static or dynamic. Let's start with the static load balancing. In static load balancing, the distribution is decided upfront before deploying servers. For example, server 1 could be reserved for French users, and server 2 for users based in the United States. The distribution can be based on various criteria, such as location, department, or IP address. In this case, each group accesses the application through specific connection points via dedicated URLs. Static load balancing doesn't require technical equipment. It means that with static load balancing, clients are always connected to the same servers. Load distribution isn't necessarily balanced between servers. One server might be more overloaded, due to more users, than the other. This method is simple to implement, but less flexible in handling load fluctuations. However, this can result in reduced system performance and inefficient resource utilization compared to more dynamic load balancing approaches that can adapt to changing conditions. Now let's move on to dynamic load balancing. This type of load balancing relies on the use of a load balancer, a specialized device for distributing loads across different servers. The load balancer continuously monitors availability and performance of the servers in real time and distributes the load accordingly. This provides adaptability to changes in workload, offering greater flexibility. And what are the advantages of dynamic load balancing? First, adding new servers to the cluster is easier, accommodating increased demand without disrupting users. Then, users experience faster response times and smooth user experience as the load is evenly distributed. Finally, if a server goes down, the load balancer automatically redirects requests to available servers, minimizing downtime. Finally, load balancers offer algorithms to manage load distribution. Among these algorithms, here are the three most commonly used ones. Round robin. In this case, a request is sent to the first server, then to the second, and so on until the last. Then, a new cycle begins. It can also be weighted round robin. In this case, load distribution is weighted based on server attributes. For example, server A might have a weight of 1, while server B has a weight of 3. This means that 25% of requests go to server A and 75% to servers of B. And finally, we have the least connection algorithm. In this case, the load balancer assigns more requests to the server with the fewest active connections. We've reached the end of this video. I hope it was informative and enjoyable. To stay in the loop with all things tech and computer science, be sure to click that subscribe button and ring that notification bell. See you soon.